Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Allah Halal family. Welcome to the channel, you beautiful people. I hope you guys are having yourself a wonderful day. In today's video, guys, we'll be reacting to a video suggested by Cheryl. Terima kasih. Thank you very much for taking the time to send me your recommendation and suggestion. The video is by Parajirit, and the link is in the description in case you guys wanted to check it out. So inshallah, we'll get started the video in just a couple of seconds. And at the end of the video, I'll share with you guys my observation and reaction. So if you want to see that, then please stay until the end of the video. With that said, guys, now let's get started. Wow. It looked like it was a rocket launcher, but the people weren't really dressed in like army clothing or uniform.
Perusahaan milik negara kembali membuat bangga mencetak rekor dalam dunia militer. Kali ini PT Dahana, PT Dirgantara Indonesia,
dan
antariksa dan penerbangan nasional berhasil memproduksi kendaraan tempur Erhan 122B.
Wow.
Alat tempur ini merupakan kendaraan peluncur roket laras banyak atau multiple rocket launcher system MLRS. Kendaraan tempur ini telah diuji dan dapat berfungsi dengan baik dan stabil sesuai spesifikasi yang diharapkan tanpa adanya kesalahan dan kerusakan baik saat endurance maupun penembakan. Prototipe peluncur roket Erhan 122B disampaikan pada pameran Alursista yang berlangsung bersamaan dengan acara rapat pimpinan Kementerian Pertahanan Republik Indonesia tahun 2020 tanggal 22 sampai 23 Januari tahun 2020 di Jakarta. Tak hanya Erhan 122B saja,
ternyata
sejumlah peralatan Inilah beberapa produk anak bangsa yang mendunia. Nomor 1, kapal cepat rudal 60 meter.
KCR-60. I think maybe these are like the KCR-60M
dirancang oleh divisi desain PT PAL Indonesia dan merupakan kapal perang hasil pengembangan dari kapal perang tipe Fast Patrol Boat FPB. 57 meter. Kapal perang ini dilengkapi dengan senjata kaliber 20 mm dan peluncur rudal anti kapal-kapal permukaan.
Ooh, look at that gun. It's shooting fire, like literally fire.
Kemampuan berlayar kapal ini bisa mencapai 5 hari dengan kecepatan jelajah 20 knots dan membawa 55 personel. KCR-60M ini biasanya bertugas menjaga perbatasan wilayah laut. Kapal perang ini ternyata menjadi incaran beberapa negara, seperti Malaysia dan Filipina. Nomor 2, kapal selam Alugoro 405.
Ooh, a submarine. Looks exactly like a whale.
Pembuatan Alugoro 405 butuh waktu sekitar 2 tahun sejak 2017. Pengerjaan awalnya dilakukan bekerja sama antara PT PAL Indonesia dengan pemerintah Korea Selatan melalui Daewoo Shipbuilding dan Marine Engineering dengan proses transfer of technology.
Okay, wow.
Spesifikasi umum kapal selam Alugoro 405 adalah berjenis diesel elektrik submarine U-209-1400 dan memiliki panjang keseluruhan 61,3 meter dengan kecepatan mencapai 21 knot ketika berada di bawah air. Kapal tersebut mampu membawa 40 kru dengan kemampuan jelajah hingga 50 hari dan didesain dengan lifetime atau usia mencapai 30 tahun dengan bobot sebesar 1460 ton saat muncul di permukaan dan bobot 1596 ton
ketika menyelam di bawah permukaan. Not they're able to find their direction and the way they should go without hitting anything. Subhanallah, you know, Allah SWT has given us human beings ilm to be able to create these things. This, I love that car. So cool.
P6 ATAV milik Satuan Detasemen Bravo, Sat Bravo 90. Pashas TNI AU.
Oh, man. Look, this is so cool, like for off-roading. This looks mean and gangster.
Sementara itu,
if they had this with like glass and like proper seats and stuff, if I had the opportunity and the chance, oh, I'd definitely buy it because look how cool it is.
Ketika kondisi bahan bakar penuh, P6 ATAV sanggup melaju sejauh 500 km. kecepatan maksimum mencapai
150 km per jam. If you guys know the manufacturers, guys, if they want to send me one to review it, hey, I'm down, you know, send them my information. I'm down to try it out and you know, maybe keep it, you know.
Nomor 4, Panzer Badak.
Wah, botak. This is the armored personnel carrier slash tank, I guess.
Tarantula buatan Korea Selatan. Kelebihannya
ada pada manuvernya.
Kelebihannya pada manuvernya yang lebih tinggi.
Bentuknya
sesuai dengan karakteristik Asia Panzer ini memiliki berat hingga 14 ton dan didukung dengan mesin diesel dari Renault, yaitu diesel inline 6 silinder turbo charger intercooler berkapasitas 10.800 cm3 yang mampu menghasilkan tenaga sebesar 340 horsepower. Panzer ini mampu mencapai kecepatan hingga 90 km/jam.
Just looks a little bit different than traditional tanks, because most tanks actually usually have the chains, right? And these ones actually have the six tires.
Lebar 2.5 meter dan tinggi 2,9 meter. Badak
ini memiliki
kemampuan jangkar yang cukup luas sekitar
600
km. Panzer Badak juga dilengkapi dengan double wishbone tanpa spring ke badak. Hal ini ditunjang dengan ban runflat 1100R22,5 yang mampu berjalan dalam keadaan tanpa angin hingga sejauh 80 km pada kecepatan tertentu.
Oh, right on the bullseye.
Pesawat CN-235.
This is a plane. CN-235. This is Indonesian made as well. Interesting is they had actually the Turkish flag. Maybe they sold it to Turkey. It's pretty cool.
Kali ini pesawat buatan anak bangsa dari PT Dirgantara Indonesia yang menjadi langganan beberapa negara seperti Senegal dan Pakistan.
Nice.
Pesawat buatan Bandung ini mampu mengakomodasi 4 mission console, mendeteksi target yang kecil, dilengkapi dengan FLIR untuk mendeteksi dan
mengidentifikasikan
target, serta mampu merekam situasi di sekitar wilayah terbang untuk evaluasi.
I was just about to say it has guns on the side and started
selepas landas dengan jarak yang
throwing fire.
Landasan yang belum beraspal.
Wow.
Kemudian pesawat ini memiliki sistem terbaru modern dan full glass cockpit.
He's gonna start dropping stuff.
Fuel tank atau teknologi yang memungkinkan pesawat tidak perlu mengisi ulang bahan bakar untuk melanjutkan penerbangan ke rute berikutnya. Tak hanya itu saja, CN-235 juga dilengkapi dengan quick change configuration, retractable landing gear, high wing configuration.
Oh. Look at the background, so beautiful. I think it might be just sunset time. This one has a Turkish flag in the back. That's snow. Yeah, it looks like it. That must be Turkey, because I know Indonesia doesn't get snow and Turkey does. That was really cool, guys. It's nice to see mashallah Indonesia producing these different equipment. That was the rocket launcher, the tank slash the armored personnel carrier, and then that was that jeep, and then I guess two different kind of planes, which is really interesting and nice to see. So then they don't rely on other countries, you know. Unfortunately, you know, that's where the world is going, for example. So they have to try to make sure that they make military hardware for defensive purposes, especially in that part of the world, because they're close to the South China Sea and there's a lot of conflicts and stuff, right? Or a lot of tension that is going on there right now, right? So they have to make sure that they have weaponry to be able to protect their people as well as their land. I love that car, guys. That's one of my favorites. Like I said, if you know the company, let them know. Send me one for review. You know, I won't charge you anything. So thank you very much, guys, for suggesting this video. I enjoyed it quite a bit. I hope you guys did too. If you did, then please don't forget to like, comment, and share. Please also consider subscribing to the channel if you guys like the content and want to show your support. That will allow me to improve the channel as well as help me reach my target of 1 million subscribers. So as always, Jermak, I say thank you very much. Shukri, merci, guys, for all your love and support. I hope you guys have yourself a wonderful day. Take care of yourself and your family. Inshallah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care. Wassalam.